Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to teach something about the chapter Force and Pressure, that is the chapter number 11 in your NCERT science book. Okay, let us now go into the lesson. Now the page that I have opened, that is the figure 11.1 is, you can see there are three pictures. The first one, you can see a goalkeeper is trying to stop a ball. And then in the second, you can see that hockey player is trying to flick the ball. And in the third, a fielder is trying to stop the ball near the boundary. So you can see that all these three show some actions. That is, the first one is trying to stop. And especially in the game of football, you can see that kicking the ball is the most common action. And then in the case of the hockey, generally they flick the ball. And in cricket, he is trying to stop the ball near the boundary. And you know that there are so many cricketing shots that you are familiar about. That is, you can say about the pull shot. Then you also have a shot called a sweep, and then drive, then a hit, and flicking. So all these actions like driving, hitting, flicking, pulling, sweeping, all these represent some action or the other. But we can call them by so many names, but can we classify them broadly into two categories? Yes, we can. We have two categories of these actions. We can broadly classify them as, that is, push and a pull. So now let us just turn the next page and see. A table is given here, that is activity 11.1 is given here. So for our convenience, the first one is solved. That is, the first one says that if you are going to move a book which is placed on the table, what are the actions that you are going to do? So you know that one thing is that you can push the book. Second is that you can pull the book towards you. And if you want to take that book from the table, you have to do lifting. So there are three actions, that is pushing, pulling, and lifting. So we can say that these two actions, these three actions can be broadly grouped as a push and a pull. Now coming to the second one, that is opening or shutting the door. Suppose you are going to open the door. So what you are going to do, you are going to pull the doorknob, which means that the action that you are going to do is pulling. And if you want to shut the door, then what you do, you push the door. So there are two main actions, for example, that is pulling and pushing. So when we are going to classify them into two categories, we have to write under the heading push, yes, and under the heading pull, yes, again. Right, so this is for the second, that is opening and shutting the door. Now coming to the third action, that is drawing a bucket of water from a well. So you know that there are two ways that we can lift the water from the well. Either you just lift it directly or use a pulley to draw the water from the well. So there can be two actions. One is pulling and the other one is lifting. So when you say that what action it is, I mean it is broadly classified as, you can say that it is the pull. So under the heading pull, you can write yes. Then coming to the fourth one, a football player taking a penalty kick. So obviously what he is going to do, he is going to kick the ball, and then he is going to sometime even flick the ball. So you can say that it is kicking and even pushing and flicking. And then you can classify this as a push. So under the heading push, you will write yes. And then a cricket ball which is going to be hit by a batsman. So there are so many ways that you can mention, like he is driving, he is hitting, he is flicking, he is pulling, he is sweeping. So there can be so many actions to represent his action, and it can be broadly classified as pulling or even pushing. So we can say under the heading push, you can write it as S, and under the heading pull also you can write it as S. Then coming to moving a loaded cart, obviously you are going to pull the cart, so you are going to write it as pulling, and that action is, you are going to write under the heading pulling. Yes. Then The last one, opening a drawer. Obviously, you will open a drawer by applying a pulling force. So, write pulling here, and the action that you have to write under the heading pull is. So, the task for you is to complete this table when I am going to upload my next video, right? Now, from all these actions, we can say, how can we define force? So, force is nothing but a push or a pull applied on an object. Now, coming to the next topic, that is, the forces are due to interaction between the two objects. So, let's see. A man stranded on the road with his car not starting. Then he asks the help of another man, and you can see in the first picture, the man is going to stand a little far away from the car. Now, can he apply a force? No. Why? Because there is no interaction between him and the car. You can see very well in the second picture, he is coming in contact with the car. There is an interaction between the two objects, so he is able to push the car. So, for any object to be pushed or pulled, there has to be an interaction between the two objects. Then, you can see the third one, that is, the two girls are pushing each other. So, again, there is going to be an interaction between the two girls for this pushing force to happen. And then, in this diagram or in this picture, you can see that two girls are playing the most common game of the girls, that is, Ringa Ringa Roses. You can see that the two girls are pulling each other. So, there is an interaction between these two girls. So, that results in this pulling force. Okay. And here again, you see another example. That is, a boy is trying to pull the cow with the help of a rope. So, here again, there is going to be an interaction between the cow, rather the rope, and the boy for this to happen. So, we can generally say that there has to be an interaction between the two objects for the force to take place or the force to act. Coming to exploring forces, that is, what will happen if more than one force is going to act on a body? Now let us see the first diagram or the first picture, where a boy is trying to push a box all alone. Then if he is going to join another boy and he is going to push the cart along the same direction, what do you think is going to happen? That they will be able to push this box much more easily. Why? Because the two forces applied by these two boys are going to add up, because they are acting in the same direction. Now coming to the next picture, where you see that the two boys are trying to push the box in the opposite directions. So either if they are going to apply the same force, what do you think is going to happen? That the box is not going to move at all. And if one boy is going to exert more force, then what is going to happen? The box is going to move in the direction of the boy who is going to apply a larger force. So, when the forces are going to act in opposite directions, what is the net force? It is going to be the difference between the two forces. Now, is there a situation when the net force can be zero? Yes, it is. When both the forces are going to act in the opposite directions, are going to be equal in magnitude, then the net force acting on the body is going to be zero. So, we can say that force is something which has a magnitude. That means we can measure the force. So, in higher classes, you will be studying about the unit in which the force is going to be measured. So, that is going to be Newton. And you know that force in higher classes you are going to study, it is a vector quantity. That means it is going to have both magnitude as well as the direction. Now, from whatever I have taught today, I would like to summarize what I spoke. The first one, the force on an object is due to a push or a pull. So that is the first point. Second, the force arises due to interaction between two objects. Then, the third one, when two forces are applied on an object in the same direction, they are going to add to each other. Then, When the forces are going to act in the opposite directions, then the net force acting on the body is going to be the difference between the two forces. And then the last one, force has both magnitude as well as direction. So I think this is the lesson that are the topic that I wanted to discuss today. And then my humble request to you all is to write down this summary in your classwork copy. At the same time, the table, that is the activity 11.1, the table 11.1 also has to be completed. Please write it in your book only, no need to write it in the copy. So the homework for today is to write the summary in points. That is, I have given you 5 points. If you have not noted on, you can just go again back to the video and check it out. Thank you.